Marge Comes in Like a Lion is a fantastic show. I've said that before in my review, but today I want to take a look at it a little bit differently, and that is exploring one of the aspects that makes the show stand out so much, and that is the visuals. In my review, I said that the show has the best visuals in anime, and I want to talk about the reason why. And that is because it is able to use visuals to tell its story in a way like no other anime. You may be able to find other shows that are more of a visual spectacle. For example, this season of Mob Psycho 100 has had amazing visuals, some of the most impressive fight scenes I've ever seen. But while they are great, they are spectacles more so than being used to tell the story. And there are other shows that have moments of brilliance. Take Tatami Galax or pretty much any work from Yuasa. A cool style and moments of amazing visuals, but for the most part, it is kind of typical once you get used to this style. Marge Comes in Like a Lion, though, has it seems like every single cut is done with a purpose, augment the storytelling in some way beyond just showing the events that happen. So today, I want to dig into a couple episodes that really stood out to me while watching to show you how Marge Comes in Like a Lion tells its story. My first example is episode 7, the first scene. This is the scene that started to show me how great the anime could be. Up until this point, it was good. The characters were interesting, it was kind of cute, and just a fun show. And the scene itself started off pretty unassuming. You had Rei and Yusuke, who is a guy from Hina School, sitting at a table in a restaurant, and the two characters didn't know each other, so it was a bit awkward. But then we came to find out that Yusuke knows about Rei and looks up to him because he's a professional shogi player. And while the twist is interesting, what makes the scene so great is how the visuals are used. There are a lot of close-ups to Yusuke's face, showing the intensity of what he is saying and the questions he is posing to Rei. Then there are some quick shots to Rei, showing how he is overwhelmed and that he doesn't have a good answer. But then the camera pulls away, symbolizing what Rei wants to do, pull away from the conversation. There's so many cuts, each with a different purpose, like to show the intensity of what they're saying, or just the awkwardness between them. There's a lot of symbolic storytelling with the scene too, and really, the entire anime. Like when Yusuke talks about believing in oneself, Rei's hair is blown back, and there's a ton of light on the outside of the window, showing how Rei is blown away by seeing there's someone who gets him, and how that is shining light on his feelings. Light is a very common metaphor throughout the entire anime too, which I'll talk about in the second scene that I'm going to bring up. We also get shots of birds flying over the river, showing Rei's mental state again, with him drowning in the river being a common symbol. Then at the end of the scene, you have Rei and Hina both overwhelmed and both grateful to each other in them being against a colored background, letting out all the tension and how great this unexpected meeting ended up being. These visual tricks are simple and obvious, but they let the story connect that much deeper, and as I said, this scene is what made me start to appreciate the show as a whole more. But to be honest, the scene itself isn't that special. What amazes me about the show is how every scene has such care, if not more. Again, every cut says something with a focus, either about the characters or the mood, or just pushing the story forward in some way. But the scene, and actually the episode, that truly blew me away was episode 34. This is one of the best episodes in all of anime, and I am going to have to get into spoilers here, by the way. This episode was a big climax to the Hina being bullying arc. One of the big things that fascinated me about this episode is how Rei isn't present at all. When I was rewatching it to make this video, I don't think he was even mentioned. And yes, this doesn't play into the visuals directly, but it is a deliberate choice that showed something additional about the story. Despite Rei not being near them, the time he spent with the characters changed them for the better, even when he is not around. The first part of the episode is titled Black Mist, the title card introducing the episode with, well, a black mist. And that sets up the episode to be an uneasy one. The colors are very muted, both with the look of the school and in the classroom. The style just feels very tense, which shows how on edge the teacher is in the class by extension. We specifically see how close the teacher is to breaking. There are cuts to the mist between the scenes too. Then, when Hina and the teacher are in the prep room, we get a couple close-ups to the teacher's eyes, which are just darting around, further driving home how on edge she is. There's also just a shot with Hina against a black background, when we get some of her internal dialogue, in a way showing how she is observing and understanding everything from the outside, or that she is a light in the darkness, or maybe both. or maybe I'm overthinking this. Hina's movements too are more normal compared to the rest of the characters this episode, like her hair spiking up, some of her more comedic movements when she is thinking, and they show how she's not part of the Black Mist or the school, how she is resisting it. One of the greatest storytelling tools is contrast, like you have battles between good and evil, or mental battles between hope and despair, and these ring so powerful because of the contrast. Or in anime, how the best horror anime are also very cute and moe because the contrast makes each of them have a stronger effect. Or just how absurd shows can also be the most emotional. Or in storytelling as a whole again, how the best characters are oftentimes a mix of strength and weakness, a topic I'd like to talk about more later. And the power of contrast is what the episode shows so well. Hina's kindness and strength against the blackness of the school that's consumed everyone else, even the teacher. When Hina brings a timeline to the teacher, there are voices calling her a brown-noser, making fun of her, and the whole scene is building from the tension from the previous scene. When she's called a brown-noser, there's a clip of the Black Mist. Then, a shot of Hina's eyes just add to the tension, along with showing Hina in black and white, how the mist is trying to consume her. And it is coming close to succeeding, but she is not going to give in. I love Hina, by the way. Hina calls Tanagi out, telling her to stop saying these insults just loud enough for her to hear. There are a couple more cuts to further set the mood of the bullying coming from all around Hina, and that just makes it even more tense. Then, all the tension from the first 3 minutes of the episode comes to a head. Hina's eyes narrowing, she baring her teeth, even kind of showing her fangs. She is angry. Justifiably so. And she runs to Tanagi's desk, knocking the timeline over, symbolizing the events that set the scene into motion. Every step of Hina's is filled with strength. And we think Hina is going to knock Tanagi out. Or maybe I wanted her to knock Tanagi out. And every cut is showing Hina coming, her balling her fist, her being ready to strike, Tanagi even being afraid and screaming. And it almost looks like glass is coming into the room too, like Hina threw Tanagi through the window. Or maybe again, I wanted that to happen. But then, Hina does it. She stands in front of Tanagi's desk with her arms crossed, saying that she would not attack her because that would be playing into Tanagi's hands. Instead, Hina stands there in a position of absolute strength. Hina's pose here reminds me of Satsuki from Kill la Kill, just how she's radiating strength. The camera shots show Tanagi looking up at Hina, both figuratively and literally. Hina's backgrounds are also brightly colored, and what we thought was glass before is light pouring into the school. At first, Hina ignores the teacher's calls to stop, adding to a position of strength that she will not be swayed just by some words of authority. But then the black mist comes back again, consuming the teacher, who now screams for Hina to stop. We then get the teacher ranting, how this always happens, how there's always bullying, and the darkness is even stronger now, with the music adding to it. Every shot here adds more power to the scene. And we understand the teacher so well, despite being a background character until 3 minutes ago. Then the next scene showed the new teacher, someone who had not been consumed by the black mist, and who then spoke with strength, with the colors now slightly less muted. The constant motif of the black mist, or lack of it, really helped to show what was going on, the conflicts inside the characters and all their dynamics. This takes advantage of the visual medium to show things that don't need to be said, making it all that more powerful. The next scene is Hina and Ikari talking, and Hina's uncertainty over the right thing to do. There is a ton of bright colors here, especially in the background, showing how Ikari is trying to help. There's emotional music, Hina crying, showing so many different emotions between the characters, of wanting to be hopeful, of Ikari's love, of Hina's uncertainty. And this is so great. We even get things like a puppy looking on, a butterfly. Just, it feels like all eyes are on Hina and Ikari, which will be very important in the next part of the episode. And the next part of the episode is called Light. Something interesting about the show in this part of the episode specifically is Ikari's name, which can be translated to light, or similar to the words Akarui, which means bright, at least based off some quick Google Translate searches and my very limited knowledge of Japanese. In a way, this really fits Ikari's personality and role in the story. She is the light to all the characters, driving out the darkness from their hearts, something that has even more meaning when you consider that last part of the episode being Black Mist. So I think them naming this chapter Light really is showing Ikari's role in the story, even if it's not quite that straightforward. When Ikari comes to the school with Hina, the colors are muted again, just like the last part of the episode. When Hina and Ikari are standing there with Tanagi and her mother, we know there's going to be a clash, which starts with a light shining behind them and the characters casting long shadows. This is a still shot, but there does not need to be movement for it to have the effect that is needed. We also get a cut of Tanagi's mother, standing in front of a black outline representing the black mist from before. Then it cuts to Ikari and Hina. Akari's eyes off screen, and Hina having black behind her, not to mention her eyes. Look at her eyes. Fueled by the mother's words, the mist is trying to consume Hina. We get more quick cuts to character faces, piano building the tension. Every cut has a purpose, even if it is a very quick one, and this adds to the feeling. The show does not need long, drawn-out exposition scenes to get the emotions across. In fact, its conciseness is what makes it work so well. The goal of these cuts is not to show the characters talking. We can hear that. It is instead to show the emotions, the conflict between the characters and within the characters as well. The visuals get wilder as the mother starts levying accusation after accusation against Hina. Instead of a black mist, the characters are replaced by black figures, or their cuts with just pure symbolism. As the accusations continue, there is even a red and black surrounding the mother, showing the violence and force in her words. Or the black around Ikari when she doesn't have words to fight back. There are pictures of Hina suffering against the black mist, bringing forth all the emotional trauma she has faced this season. We see Ikari defeated, water surrounding her, showing her drowning in her failure, a symbol we have seen before with Rei. There are a couple of cuts with Ikari against the black background, a white outline around her, showing how she is trying to be a light for Hina, though the outline fades against the mist, showing how she has failed here. Then Hina. I love Hina. Hina reaches out to Ikari, her hand a white outline against the black background. When Hina begins speaking, the black background is replaced with a bright one. And as Hina and Ikari walk away, there are a couple more cuts with minimal movement. Typically, this is a bad thing. Minimal movement means that the animators were not putting in the care that they needed to into the scene. But here, the lack of movement is intentional, showing the mental state of the characters. When we get to the nurse's room, it's now filled with bright color. Ikari apologizes to Hina for failing her, and in a way, the bright colors don't make sense. The black mist is still there, or it should be. The bullying hasn't stopped, but Hina gives the answer. That having people on her side like Ikari is enough to make her happy, and that gives her strength. There's a cut showing what they did to Chiho, showing the emotional pain that Chiho felt and Hina felt because of her love for Chiho. We then cut back to the nurse's office with Hina giving her final answer, that she doesn't have a single reason to waste her life on people like the bullies. Then as Hina say that, we get cuts of the classroom being filled with light, showing Hina breaking through the darkness as she yells that just by surviving this year, she wins. There is even a cut showing the darkness evaporating around her. Have I said I love Hina yet? Her face is filled with determination and strength, plus the final cut of the episode shows the school with colorful background. Even if the struggles are not over for Hina, she will overcome. Going back to the episode title, we see it written as the kanji for light, which is pronounced Hikari. This might be speculation again, but Hikari is sort of a combination of both Hina and Ikari's names, showing that together the both of them are light to the school and each other. Despite Ikari not being able to stand up for Hina the way she wanted to here, Ikari gave Hina strength, and the reason Hina is the person she is because of the way Ikari and her grandpa raised them. You could take this a step further too, seeing that Hina's strength is in part because of Rei and the light that Rei shone into her life. And the reason Rei is able to shine into her life is because of the light that she and Ikari shone into his. Though maybe this is me just being an overthinker. Either way, I think it's interesting. So that is the episode. I could talk about the other episodes, but well, this video is pretty long as it is. And I feel like this at least illustrates how the show does what it does. There's also that shogi match between that older guy during the championship. Yeah, that one was good. But the combination of storytelling and visuals in this episode is my personal favorite of the series. So thank you for watching. I hope you've enjoyed my videos about March Comes In Like a Lion. I might be doing more. Just let me know if you want to see that. I really do love this anime, so I feel it definitely deserves this closer look. Go check it out if you haven't already. Anyway, thank you so much for watching, and I will see you all next time.